Next, we're going to learn about the user exits in production planning. Now, user exits is one of the important questions in interview. So you just need to get an understanding of what a user exits is and where it is used and what are the examples of user exits. So let us understand what is user exit. User exit is just an ABAP code which is not provided in the standard SAP system, but function could be added later into the code. So in general terms, what this means is, for example, there's a extra functionality which is not there in the standard transaction that you're using, but you want to add it. So this can be added by the ABAP coding. So I'll give you some example in the next screen. So what type of examples we can see for the user exits, and this is done by the ABAP consultant. And for example, you wish to add a custom field in the production order screen. Okay, so there's a custom date you want to enter, custom any quantity, XYZ quantity you want to enter, anything, any custom field, or you want to enter a serial number or some extra whatever field. It can be a numeric field, it can be a character, the alphanumeric field. So these are the examples, the function of the user exits. Now here we'll talk about some examples for the user exits. So there are a few examples here. For example, this is a user exit number PPCO0021. Again, you do not to remember this number, but this is just for a general understanding. So this user exit can be used to check any specific condition for order release. For example, whenever you release the order, and the business wants to check some extra functionality when releasing the order, and this functionality is not there in standard SAP, then we can implement this user exit by the ABAP consultant, and he can enter the coding. So whenever order will be released, those extra condition will be checked. For example, you want to check that whether the material is blocked or not. When you release the order, you want to check that whether there is a block on the material master or not. So that's an example. Then some other example are this user exit for modifying menu entries. What menu entries are? For example, when you open the production order CO02, so if I open this one, so the top entries you see here on the top, these are the menu entries. So if you want to modify, you want to remove something, you want to add something, so for this you can use the second one. Then we have another user exit to check for order changes from the sales order. That means any change we do in the sales order, which is again from the sales order we created the production order, for example, then any changes done in the sales order should be reflected to the production order. So you can use this exit. Then we have an enhancement to specify default for the fields in the order header. So that means when you open the order or create the order, then some of the fields should have a default value. For example, it could be a date, it could be something else. So for that, you can use this one for the default values. Then this exit when saving the production order. So when you're saving the order, then there's a specific check you want to do. Then you can use this one, that it will do that check. And this next is for release control for automatic batch determination. So that's another topic in batch determination. When you're using the batch determination, then to release control, you can use this one. And mass changes user exit. That means the mass change transaction we use, like COIS transaction for doing any mass change. So in that one, you want to add another extra functionality, then you can use this exit. So that's all about the user exits, and thank you very much.